Hello everyone. I hope you're having a good Thursday. Welcome to Pawfology. Today I'm on my way to Blue Collar Coffee. Blue Collar Coffee is in the Bottle Works Hotel, and I'm walking by. This is the Cunningham Restaurant Group. Cunningham is a very popular place in Indy. They own a lot of restaurants. So Cunningham owns a lot of high-scale restaurants, and that will be kind of important for what I'm about to talk about. So I'm going to Blue Collar Coffee Shop, and I might go to the garage to Herculean and grab a lunch. But Blue Collar is, they have two other locations in Wisconsin. And I thought they were a local place in Wisconsin, like, oh, that's cool. They're, you know, they're trying to branch out into Indy. Well, come to find out, they're owned by the Geronimo Restaurant Group. And the Geronimo, well, not restaurant group, the Geronimo Hospitality Group. The Geronimo Hospitality Group owns a ton of hotels in Wisconsin. And they have, they own the Bottle Works and the Garage, which is like a food court area in downtown Indy. And they own Iron Works. And if you're in Indy or that this area, you might know of Iron Works because it's where Provision is at. That's a restaurant, a pretty nice Cunningham restaurant. So that building back there is the Cunningham Restaurant Group. And I found it interesting that Cunningham has a restaurant in a Geronimo Hospitality hotel, even because Geronimo Hospitality has their own restaurants, like Blue Collar. They have fancy restaurants. So I was, you know, I wonder why they went with Provision to be placed, a Cunningham restaurant to be placed in their own hotel, if that makes sense. So all that to say, I'm going to Blue Collar. They're, I guess, placed into different locations in the Geronimo Hospitality hotels and stuff. And we'll see how it is. I looked the other ones up online and they do have pretty good reviews. So I'm expecting it to be fairly good. It looks like a cool coffee shop. So, but I don't know how cool it will be since it's in a hotel, but hey, I mean, I went to a really cool coffee shop in Nashville in a hotel and it was awesome. So in the Omni Hotel, I think it was like a branch of a local coffee shop in Nashville or something. Yeah, you know, I do wonder if Cunningham would want to be purchased by Geronimo or something, because Cunningham seems to be only, there's another Cunningham restaurant livery. Cunningham seems to be only, a restaurant group and not a hospitality group. I originally thought Iron Works was owned by Cunningham, the hotel. And it's like a really nice hotel. Actually, Peter and Alex stayed there at some point. It's a very nice hotel in Indy. And I thought that was owned by Cunningham. All that to say, I'm excited to go to this coffee shop. Oh, look at this. This is behind the Oregon place. This place right here cleans organs, they build organs as well. And should I turn around? I think I should. Can I go this way? Yeah, I should turn around. Well, I'll see you in a bit. I'm first gonna go to Herculean and then I'm gonna go to the coffee shop. I hope you're all having a good Thursday. Here's a Pokey bike. Do any of you like Pokey? Here's Herculean. I get some of my lunches here sometimes. There's turkey bolognese, mac and cheese. That pork mac and cheese is super good. I really like it. I've never had the jambalaya. I've had the teriyaki chicken right there. It's pretty good. But my favorite is this one right here. Pulled pork, broccoli, and sweet potato. Very good. This is Blue Collar Coffee. And as you can see, there's a lot of tables right there. A lot of people from the hotel and even in downtown will come here and work. There's a lot of space, so it's pretty nice. And there's space outside as well. And they also sell like your typical pastries, cake pops, salads. And they have quite a bit of merch. And I see they sell Ruby Coffee, which I've never heard of, but I assume it's a Wisconsin coffee brand. But they also have mugs, I guess a hat, if you wanted a hat from the coffee shop. And that's about all. They have, I might have said this, but they have smoothies and teas there as well. And you can kind of see it's more of a rustic vibe. There's a lot of things in this hotel that are Coca-Cola related because it's the Bottle Works Hotel. So, but yeah, this is the inside of Blue Collar. Also, this is one of only a couple coffee shops in downtown Indy that is open at 6 a.m. One being Caffeine Coffee and the other one being Starbucks, and they open at 6:30. So that's a plus if you want to get up and get some coffee in the morning. So I just got out of Blue Collar Coffee, got my coffee, and it's starting to rain. I did not know it was supposed to rain, but also I don't really look at the weather that much. But I got my coffee, so I'm gonna try it. It's all right. It's a very bold, generic, with a little acidity coffee. You know, for being hotel coffee, it's pretty good. And that's what I would consider this. It's just a hotel coffee shop. There's a lot of better, I haven't tried every drink, but just like going inside, it was kind of touristy, obviously made for guests. There's better places more than likely to get coffee. Probably even Certain Feelings. I mean, I guarantee you Certain Feelings, which is just 100 feet away, has a higher quality coffee. But is it better than Starbucks? It's better than Starbucks, just plain coffee. You know what I mean? So, yeah. I guess if I had to choose, I would choose this place. Unless, I haven't had their iced coffee, so their iced coffee might not be comparable. You know, I do kind of like Starbucks's cold brews, Starbucks's iced coffee to a certain extent. So, that's my thoughts. Not bad. They're very nice. So, it is more of a hotel coffee shop. So, okay, I'm gonna go. It's raining. Okay, I'm back. And I have one more thing I wanted to mention. So this morning, yesterday I got this. It's called Just Egg. And I just wanna give my thoughts about it. If you have ever tried this, let me know. What do you think about this? I'm gonna give this, so I tried it this morning. Okay, I didn't even tell you what this is. Just Egg is a vegetarian, I think it's vegetarian, egg substitute. So it's made with plants. I don't think it's vegan though. Yeah, I don't think it's vegan because it uses, I don't know why it's not vegan. So, but it uses plants and it's a substitute for eggs. Okay, and it's supposed to make like a scrambled egg, but it's just made synthetically in a lab that mimics a scrambled egg. Okay, so here's my thoughts. It is a very intense egg flavor and it's really hard to describe it, but whatever they use to make that flavoring of egg is very strong. And it's extra chewy. Okay, all that to say, it's a very weird taste to it. It has onion in it. It has mung bean protein. I definitely taste the onion in there. It's very strong, but you know, it's interesting. I'm gonna give it another try. I think the taste just really caught me off guard and the texture did too. I think maybe you have to, it can't be made, for me, I couldn't eat it as an omelet because it's just too weird and squishy and it's squeaky, that's what it is. It's a squeaky egg versus your regular egg is more fluffy and I don't know, has that fluffy texture to it. This is more, you know, kind of synthetic. It is synthetic. It's a different texture than an egg with a lot stronger flavor. But, you know, I bet if you mixed it with some other ingredients or even put powder into it, it might be pretty good. Like a seasoning, it would probably be pretty good. So that's all. I just wanted to show you that. If you like this, let me know. I mean, if you've used it, do you, you know, make eggs with, do you just keep it plain? Do you do something else with it? I'm not sure I would buy it again, but hey, I give it a try. You know, why not? I bet it would be fine in a fried rice, you know, something to kind of mask that texture and flavor. But you know, it's definitely interesting, and we'll probably see a lot more products like this. You know, the market's just growing so fast. So I did see that you can make egg whites, you know, like egg meringue, okay, with chickpeas. And maybe you already know this, but if you get garbanzo peas, which I think, are those the same as chickpeas? Anyways, you get those garbanzo beans and out of a can, and you get the water out of it, and that water from that can of beans will whip up into a meringue. Isn't that crazy? And it's like, it's wild. So I thought that was really interesting. I might try that sometime. There might be more steps to it, but that's a general idea. And you can use that bean water as well as an egg substitute. It will combine ingredients the same way that an egg combines ingredients. So I'm gonna try that sometime. Well, that's everything. I hope you have a great Thursday. I hope you have a great Friday. It's almost the weekend. And yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow's vlog might be up really, really late because we'll be out so long, but that's okay. So I'm gonna go. If no one's told you this today, you are loved, and this world's a better place because you are here. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.